Happy birthday to Mike Simmons, who turned 80 last week. Mike is the highlight sponsor for this match, kindly gifted on behalf of his family. And Sholing are forever indebted to his tireless efforts behind the scenes. The Boatmen have recorded 3 clean sheets in the last 4 as Gosney searches for another donor against Evesham United. The McCoy Stadium was bombarded with terrible wins ahead of this one, as Sholing looked to make it 4 wins in a row.
Dave, you face Evesham today off the back of 3 successive wins. How confident are you in your team that they can get a result today?
Well, I said to the lads for the game, I mean, things change drastically in football, you know. As short as 10 days ago, we were struggling to find a win, and now we've got 3 in a week. But, you know, this league is a very tough league. Obviously, the conditions are going to be against both teams today, I think. But we need to get the ball down and play as much as we can. They're going to be, they've only lost, I think, 1 game in the last 5, so they're going to be up for it. But if we take our chances, I'm quite confident.
Lee, obviously, it's your 3rd game now in charge of Evesham. Do you know what to expect from your side?
Yeah, more or less. I know there's a bit more to come. We played okay in the 2 games. We was better on Wednesday night against Larkhall, losing the lead a couple of times. But I know there's more to come.
And in terms of today, what are you expecting from your side? What result would you be happy with?
Yeah, a win. As I've said to them, really, every team's capable of beating all the other teams in the league. Teams will lose games, whether they be good at home, good or A, wherever it is. So we've come in to get 3 points, and hopefully we can do well as well.
Sholing kick off from right to left as Evesham decides to switch ends. It didn't faze the Boatmen as Dan Mason had this chance within the opening minutes, with a fierce volley dipping over the bar. Sidibe looked lively down the right before a clearance fell to Jordan Lim, who found Brandon Smalley with his curled effort falling wide of Gosney's post. The away side continued to threaten and had this chance before the referee blew up for offside. Dan Mason found himself in space down the left and his drilled ball into Targett was somehow scrambled away from danger. Strong play from Sidibe allowed him to find space down the right again, but his curling effort glanced over the crossbar. Sholing were awarded a free kick 30 yards out for this challenge, much to the disagreement from the away side. Conor Whiteley stepped up and forced Lewis Clayton to tip the ball onto his crossbar and out for a corner. Again, Sidibe managed to generate space for a shot, but his fizzing effort again missed the target. This pinpoint ball found the head of Dan Mason, but the striker wasn't able to get the desired connection. A combination of a tackle from Hoole and a pass from Roundell allowed Whiteley to bend his effort inches away from making it 1-0. The wind caused issues as Clayton's clearance wasn't decisive and eventually Dan Mason's first time effort wasn't troubling the Evesham goalkeeper. A mistimed clearance allowed Sidibe a chance, but Gosney flew to his left to deny what looked a certain goal. Eventually, after a few swipes of the ball, Belmonte's effort was deflected for a corner. The corner was too high for everyone, and Brad Targett managed to get ahead on the ball, eventually fell to the feet of Nicholls before Targett received the ball back. The winger's first time ball was perfect for Whiteley to latch onto, and the striker showed composure and patience to wait for his opportunity before smashing the ball into the back of the net for Sholing to take the lead. The goal scorer had a chance soon after, when he brought down a high ball before unleashing this effort that clattered off the crossbar for the second time in the game. This first time ball allowed Targett a chance to drive at goal, and the winger floated a delicate flick over the keeper, but couldn't beat the woodwork. Unfortunate for the winger. Evesham piled on the pressure during the last 10 minutes, and this long throw caused a bit of danger before being flicked over the bar. Another long throw soon after eventually fell to the feet of Tom Chamberlain, but Robin Nicholls pulled off this heroic block to prevent the away side. With only seconds left of injury time, Chamberlain again tried from distance. With the wind carrying it, Gosney's blushes were spared as he watched the ball trickle out for an Evesham corner. The corner proved wasteful as it failed to beat the first man, and the referee brought proceedings to a halt. Here are the thoughts from both managers via subtitles as the wind continued to cause havoc. But first, matchday sponsor Mike Simmons awarded Ryan Gosney with a commemorative plaque for his 300th appearances for the Boatmen, and Conor Whiteley for his man of the match performance.
Lee, an unfortunate day today with really a match that could have gone either way. What was your thoughts on the game?
Yeah, exactly that. Yeah, fine lines. Good game of football in the conditions, I thought. Both teams trying to play. It was just a tight game. Unfortunately, on the wrong end of that. The chance there we had, we should have scored just before they scored, really. With the 1v1, they got the other end and they scored. It's a similar type of goal, yeah.
Both teams had probably the same amount of chances.
Yeah.
Does it give you confidence, obviously, coming here, giving Sholing a good game, looking at the table, really? Does that give you confidence for the rest of the season?
Yeah, of course it does. We've got a good summer. Like I said, all teams can beat everyone in this league. And we're in that pot, we can beat anyone. We've just got to get a bit more consistent, really. We'll see how it goes. We've got another toughie next week. Likewise, it's just another game of football we can win. So that's what we'll be trying to do.
Top line, nice one.
A really hard-fought win for Sholing in a match where both sides had chances. What was your thoughts on the game?
Well, I think both teams did really well in plus three conditions. I mean, this ruins football. We've hit the woodwork three times, so I think it was a real good game, and it was in many ways. But I think we had opportunities to make the scoreline a little bit better than it was. They had a couple of good players, number 11, number 10, first half. We talked about them all the time. We thought we sort of like controlled the game a little bit. So, and obviously, we're going to be under the cosh the last 10 minutes. With this win, obviously, I think it was a really good win, so we did really well. Boston was a tremendous save as well. Take that into consideration. But yeah, I mean, I was really pleased today because, we did all right first half, but. No panic station, but just for the second half, I thought it was a ruin to the game.